Hello, this is a video about how to push pages from the SFUSD curriculum out to SeeSaw. So this is an example of from third grade, from unit 3.8. And in this case, you can see that the independent work has students doing some work that's in the SFUSD curriculum. So this slide, you would do with your whole class. And so with this, this is part of the launch. And then on this slide, it says that you're going to be, kids are going to be exploring this independently. So I'm going to go to SeeSaw now. And in SeeSaw, I'm going to create an activity for them to work on. So I'm going to click on add. I see I'm under activities, add, and post student. Whoops, no, not that. I'm going to go back to add and assign an activity. And in the activity library, I'm going to say create a new activity, and I'm going to call this dividing up the playground. And the instructions I'm going to get from that slide, these are the instructions. The school will have three gardens, the gardens are all the same size, etc. I'm going to copy that, paste it here into SeeSaw. I could add voice instructions if I wanted. I'm not going to add them right now, but I am going to add multimedia instructions or an example. And to do that, I'm going to take a screenshot of this picture. So I'm going to take a screenshot, just this part of it, divide into four equal parts. And then I'm going to go back to SeeSaw, and I'm going to upload that screenshot from my desktop. And there it is. I'm going to say good. And now I can record here. I can show this as an example, which I'll do right now. So how can I divide this into four equal parts? Grab this pen and let me see if I can make a line down the middle of this playground. All right, that's two parts. And now I'll make a horizontal line. Now I have one, two, three, four parts. They're not perfectly equal, but they're pretty good. Okay, so I've added this to my SeeSaw activity, and now I'm gonna add a template for student responses. In order to do this, I need to go to the lesson, which is right here, and I need to open that and I need to download it as a PDF, because if I upload a PDF to SeeSaw, then students can annotate it. So I'm going to say file, download, PDF, and then I can go back to SeeSaw and I can add the template for student responses. I can upload it from my computer. And there it is, the entry task. And now students are going to be able to annotate that. I've done my activity, I've done my new activity, and I can assign it to my class. I'm going to assign it to Learning SeeSaw Grade 3. Assign. Oh, it won't let me assign because it's hidden behind the screencastify screen. But that would be my next step, would be assign. Oh, maybe I can hide this. Can I? Yes. Assigned to one class. And there it is. It's assigned. I'm done. When I go back to my class, I can see that there's dividing up playgrounds. It's been assigned to the task. Hope this was helpful to you.